I consider Animal Crossing New Leaf to be one of the best Nintendo 3DS games ever made, and I love it for a lot of reasons, but probably the biggest reason why I adore this game is because I just simply never get bored of it. It was always a game I could just pick up and play and have a great time, but the 3DS is coming to a close, and the Nintendo Switch is going to be taking its place once the 3DS officially dies. So in this video, I want to talk about why Animal Crossing is coming to the Nintendo Switch. In order to understand why Animal Crossing is coming to the Nintendo Switch, we first must look at how the series even started in the first place. The original Animal Crossing launched for the GameCube initially on April 14th, 2001. IGN gave the game a 9.1 out of 10. The writer of the review, Peter Schneider, said the following about the game. "Parents who are looking for the perfect game to play with their kids, take note. It doesn't get better than this. It's rare that a game comes along that's so well designed that it breaks down age differences and can be enjoyed by kids and grown-ups alike." But the game never reached its full potential for its sales, probably due to the fact that the GameCube itself wasn't selling very well. The original Animal Crossing took advantage of a lot of the GameCube's features. Probably the feature utilized the greatest was the GameCube's real-time clock that tracks the real world's time 24/7. My favorite feature the game used was its four seasons feature. Basically, the game would track what season it is in the real world through the clock feature and change the in-game season to the real world season. This adds a special charm to the game that makes it even more enjoyable, at least in my opinion. But here's one of the biggest problems with the game. You have to be tethered to the TV to play it. Now, I find that this makes the experience even more memorable, but still, this is the perfect type of game for when you're on a road trip or on the go. Do you see where I'm going with this? Fast forward to 2012, when Animal Crossing New Leaf launched on the Nintendo 3DS. I've already talked about why I love this game, but the game itself received rave reviews. Like its much older counterpart for the GameCube, people commented on how much replayability the game had. However, unlike the first game in the series, New Leaf received a bit more love. IGN gave the game a 9.6 out of 10. Metacritic gave the game only a 1% increase over the original, which even though that isn't a huge difference, it's still a good rating. Due to the great sales of the 3DS, the game sold very well, and the game's considered to be the 3DS's 7th best-selling game of all time, selling around 11 million copies, putting it right behind Super Mario 3D Land at 11.40 million. Alright, so moving on past that little history bit. Why should the Animal Crossing series make its way over to the Nintendo Switch? Well, I mean, it should be obvious at this point. The point I was trying to make with that history part is that people love playing Animal Crossing at home, but people love playing it more on the go. What does the Nintendo Switch do that makes it stand out from the rest? It's a game console that lets you take it anywhere. If you are like me and you love the charm of playing a game like this at home, you can with the power of the Nintendo Switch dock. And if you are also like me and you absolutely adore playing Animal Crossing on the go, have at it with the power of the Nintendo Switch. Plus, the Nintendo Switch is the most powerful portable console ever, so the game would look leaps and bounds better than its predecessors. On top of that, you can use the Joy-Con's features such as HD rumble and motion detection to offer new, more unique gameplay types that could enhance the experience. Want to dig a hole right into the ground? Just move the Joy-Cons down, just to name a random example off the top of my head. So, in conclusion, I think that Nintendo should make an Animal Crossing game for the Nintendo Switch. And if I were to take a wild guess when the game would be announced, I'd say that you should expect it for this upcoming E3 in 2018. I would also love to hear your thoughts on this topic in the comments, and because my channel is so small, I'll try to reply back to you. So I hope you did enjoy this video. If you did, then please share it on social media. I'll have links to my social medias in the description, and see you.